in the next cycle, in cycle 10, this instruction will be able to dispatch. This is our add. And it's going to execute in cycles 10 and 11. So in cycle 12, it's going to try to write its result. So in cycle 11, nothing really happens other than the execution of these two instructions. But in cycle 12, what's going to happen is this instruction is going to broadcast its result. So we will mark that it broadcasts the result. We will find the register that matches AD2, which is F6, and overwrite the value of F6 with the new value, which is the -9.6 plus -2.5. So it's going to be -12.1. So this is the value of AD2. And now we're going to unrename this to make future accesses read the new F6. And no instructions was waiting for. Note that this was the last instruction in our sequence, so nobody was really waiting for this result. But this instruction is done now. So we can free this reservation station. Now nothing will really happen until cycle 17. In cycle 17, this multiply is finally going to broadcast its result. We're multiplying 2.5 times 2.5 and then, you know, minus. And that value goes into F0. So F0 is going to become whatever that result is. We're not going to even try to compute that. It's going to be unrenamed here. It's going to put that value over here. And now the divide is finally ready to go. And we're going to free this reservation station. So finally, in cycle 18, the divide is ready to go. It's been dispatched. Add 40 cycles. So it's going to be in cycle 58 that we finally produce that result. So nothing really happens until cycle 58, at which point this value is broadcast. Register F10 gets to grab that value. We unrename this. We free this reservation station. We look at who is waiting for it, but nobody is. And that concludes our example.